Hello everyone, you're back with Caitlin from Banger Inc. Today we're going to be looking at how to add an accounts receivable client to your database so you can bill time against them. So first we're going to open up our sample company and we're going to navigate to AR on the left hand side. And we're going to drop down to 3-6 receivable clients. This is going to be the main hub as how we enter clients for accounts receivable. In the sample company, we already have some records in here. So this number is going to, in this field, pre-populate the next numerical value that is available. Here we'll have our drop down or a drill down button that will allow us to see all of our clients on different categories that we assign them. So first we'll want to enter in a client name. We'll just do test for this example. The client name should be their full name of their organization or the name of the individual. The short name can be anything that you want it to be. It can be a reduced version or a consolidated version of their full name, or if you are implementing a new system, you can assign them an alphanumeric code for that client name. For this example, we will just keep them the same. The statuses, we can add new records to it. So in this example, for the sample company, they've assigned them to either be a contact, prospect, current customer, customer or 2 to 5 or 5 to 10 years, or do not accept contract again. If you don't like these options, click the bented arrow, and this is how we can edit these options. Override this by double-clicking it and retyping over what it is. Once you're done, hit the save button and that'll upload to that new status. This is a required field that will need to be indicated prior to saving the record. When we look at types, these are an additional classification that will be pulled on reporting if your organization wants to go forward with this. This would be more of what they do or what actions they perform on that client. To edit this, you can again select the bented arrow and edit these. In the notes category, this is where oftentimes customers will put in different examples. So maybe hospitals and schools are in one category, they'll put in a couple examples of that for each type name that they select. Again, this isn't a required field, but it can be helpful when looking at organizing them if you have a lot of clients for AR. Nothing down here is a required field in order to save this record. However, I always suggest putting in the address of the organization or the client that you're submitting. And that way, when it comes time for a tax district, you can insert one. For this, let's just put this in Kansas City, Missouri. So if we put this here, we'll put 64136. The only tax districts that are in here are in the state of California and then the state of Nevada, but this helps put a tax on things like material or labor or subcontracts. That way, if you know that they're in Kansas City, Missouri, you can assign them the correct tax district. And then here, we will put in our due terms that we know for this organization. The format for due terms needs to be the number of days, and then either DY, MO, or TH. DY is for 30 days, MO is for month, and then TH would be the specific day that they need to pay on. Again, not a required field, but it does help later on when we look at invoicing on the due terms if that's already submitted per client. Down here in the contact field, you can insert names that are associated with that client, job title, and then contact information for that. That way, when you submit this record, it'll go into the contacts for that record. So it looks like here on this example, we have John Clark, who's a project manager, and his contact information. That way, I can manage him in the contact section. Other addresses for this example can be billing and shipping location. When you save this record, and we'll see this here in just a moment, if this was blank, so if we overrid this and did not have anything in the billing address, it'll always want to pull this address that we put in under general information to their billing address as well. That way we make sure that the invoices and the payments are going to the correct location. Again, here would be billing and payment information. And sales and marketing is a more internal approach to tracking who sold this, who's the manager, and different contact points for that client. Once we're done, we can save this record, and this is where it's going to ask us, do we want to copy the physical address to the billing address? If it's the same, just hit yes. If it's no, click no and go back and edit the billing address for that client. And there we have it. With the statuses that you've selected for your clients, that's how it's going to classify when you go to view all clients. So hit the drill down button. Sorry, this will classify by type here. The different types of clients that we've categorized them by. So if you have more than 50 clients, I would suggest putting in types. That way when you hit all clients, you're not scoundreling through multiple records. That would be kind of overwhelming. This is an easier way to classify your types of clients. And there you have it. If you have any questions or want to dig a little deeper, please feel free to reach out to me at coordinator@bangerinc.com. I'd love to get some time scheduled with you. Thank you.